You must be one of the new settlers. Welcome to Gilded Vale. You'll be pleased to know that we've had some recent vacancies here. Of course, we'll need to make some inquiries first. The inestimable Lord Radric the Seventh has taken great pains to insulate our town from Widewind's legacy. Have you ever conceived a hollowborn child? Are you absolutely certain? Lord Radric has made it his first priority to eliminate this scourge from our village. I should warn you, stranger. Here in Gilded Vale, we have a special place for dissidents, charlatans, and those who would hide a curse in our midst. His lordship's wife is with child and due any day now. Without his approval, I shan't be able to find you a permanent settlement. It will have to wait until after the birth. We can continue our interview then, after the bell tolls from Radric's hold to signal my lord's new heir. In the meantime, you can find temporary accommodations at the inn just southwest of here. Whatever your problem, it sounds like a matter for an animancer. However, the only animancer in Gilded Vale isn't in any condition to speak. Consider yourself fortunate. After she failed Lord Radric, we saw to it that she wouldn't profit from the misplaced trust of others. A bad cure is often worse than none at all. But if you're set on finding a bottle of troll piss or a dead Audra pebble to rub on your forehead, you're welcome to check her pockets. A little corpse stink is nothing when you're digging for shit. My advice, however, is to be satisfied that you escaped and leave it at that. Keep out of...
Listen!
Two tolls. Let that be the last.
Three. Gods have mercy.
It seems your arrival is ill-timed. Three bells toll only for the death of a Radric. I fear Lord Radric's heir is lost, or else hollowborn, and so lost all the same. You should tread carefully. Circumstances have changed a great deal.
I meant no offense. Let's put this matter to rest over a round, shall we? My treat.
Hoping to soothe our pride with a few Adira coppers, eh? We don't need your coin.
Go on. Say it again. I'm itching for an excuse.
Why, you're itching for the kindling touch of your sister, you cocksfeather!
I'll cut that barrel-looking tongue out of your head!
This is a misunderstanding. I didn't say whatever it is you think I said. We've nigh quarrel.
That's where you're wrong.
Not quite how I hoped to get to know the neighbors. Thank you for your timely assistance with that. Awkward courtesy is a rare pleasure in these parts. Though your accent suggests that you are no more local than I. Well, I suppose introductions are in order after that little fiasco. Aloth Corvisor, at your service. Well, I'm a wizard by training, and an adventurer by necessity. I was born in the Seathwood, part of the mainland of the Adir Empire, and both of my parents served the nobility, which afforded me an education for which I am grateful. However, there were no open positions in those houses, and so I decided to seek new means in a new land. And how exactly did you come to be here? In Gwythan Ruins? Oh, those can be dangerous places during the best of times, which these are not. In half the locals would arrest you for trespassing and the rest would kill you outright. I'm curious, what exactly did you find there? And you survived? I've heard such a thing was impossible. But it seems you either have a knack for timing or the favor of the gods. An excellent question. I came looking for fresh air and cheap land. Instead, the magistrate gave me directions to the inn and a story about the local lord's expectant wife. But I take it that's a familiar tale. Indeed. The local lord has searched far and wide for similar specialists. He has rid himself of them almost as desperately. As should I, given recent events. It's just as well. I've had enough of the watered wine and lumpy beds at the inn. They say even the owner tired of the place. Just up and left one day. It explains. Excellent. I shall follow you.
How do you do? guts keep you. Guts keep you. I've got it. Finished. Hail and well met.
Were you looking for someone in that tree? I could introduce you.
Have you come here for me, dear? Or have you gotten lost? Ah, it is both, I think. Yes? The world looks a little different than it used to, is that it? Feels like you're noticing things for the first time that have always been there? You have seen past the shroud. It only takes an instant. Your soul remembers, yes? Remembers how it sees when it leaves the body, like being reminded of a dream you had forgotten. You are a watcher now, and a watcher you will stay. What indeed? Long hours have many animancers spent studying such things. Not I, though. Not I. I'll tell you what I know, though, since fair is fair. And here we are, visiting, you and I, and it reminds me of better times. Souls pass on, some say through Audra stones, which are the blood veins of the world. They leave the world for a time and are reborn into it, sometimes more than they were before, but usually less and seldom the same. For all souls, there is a time where they do not live, yet have not passed on, and those souls roam the world, same as you or I, either living or lost. But no one sees them because they have forgotten how. A watcher sees, though, knows what to look for. And sometimes they know a person just by looking at them, know where they've been in ages past when their bodies were other bodies, see memories even their honor can't recall. A wonder to behold when all goes well, a wonder! Oh, nothing to be afraid of, I'm sure. It's just much to take in for some. Sometimes there's trouble sleeping or other difficulties. You should see old Meyerwald. He could tell you much more than I. A watcher just like you. Helped many in his day. Took up in an old keep no one would claim. Not far, not far. Kadnua, beyond the Black Meadow. He will welcome the company. Did you now, dear? My, that would be something, wouldn't it? Could be luck, could certainly be. A storm can be a careless thing. Or maybe it got its hands around your soul, but couldn't pick it up. A soul can be heavy if it stayed in one piece through its time. Strong souls, we call them in the trade. Called, I mean. Called them. Those days are all behind me, no? Oh, yes. Entropy. Rimagan's work. We know little of why or how. We lose pieces of ourselves when we die, and pick up pieces of others when we are born again, but less than what we lost. We try to stop it with the animantic sciences, but with little success. A very small few resist Rimargan's influence, and stay together through some force of defiance, at least for a time. But they all succumb eventually, I think. Me? I'll bore you to tears, though. Goodbye, my dear. It was lovely visiting.
Seventeen and a half.
Let's go! Can't move now!
Lava will be on seek!
Let's go!
Gods keep you.
Thank you.
lava will be on seek!
This is the home of the man responsible for those hanging corpses. You don't plan on knocking, do you? I'll see what I can find.
Thank you. Thank you.